When I say this thing that happened to me around 2011, it wasn't a turning point for me. It was more of a definitive point, right? It was me hearing something new that I had never heard before. And what it entailed was basically this. We were just beginning to really hit it radio. And we had been trying to get on radio. I mean, that's what you need. You need that radio song, you know? Otherwise, it doesn't get out to the whole world. Well, we were finally hitting it radio. We were going on tour with massive secular bands at the time. And some of these bands were doing, I mean, they were doing arenas, 5,000, 6,000, 8,000 people a night, you know, 10,000 some of them. I could never dream of doing a tour that big. And so all of a sudden we were there. And long story short, after a show, there was this kind of like tour party at a bowling alley, and I'd gone. And there was a bunch of industry folks there. And when I say industry people, I mean publicists, radio programmers, you know, DJs. There were some famous people there. There were some professional athletes there, models. You know, it was just like this was the place to be. I had gone so I could hang out with the bands. They had invited me. I was the opening band on the slot, and I was like, I don't want to be the opening band. That's like, no thanks. I don't want to come to your big party. So I'll come. I'll go bowling. Well, it ended up that somebody said, "Hey, John, I want to talk to you." And I didn't know they even knew who I was. And it was a, you know, fairly big mover and shaker in the industry. And basically, the story goes, him saying, "Hey, you guys could be the next biggest band in the world, but you have to stop talking about Jesus." And he kind of went through a spiel of why. And then he's like, "Hey, I'm not telling you to not be a Christian. I'm not saying to like not believe in Jesus. Stop talking about it. Don't do Christian interviews. Don't say you are a Christian band. You need to disassociate from that because people don't take it seriously." And so we were having the talk, and I don't hold it against him. He was trying to do me a favor. He was being really nice. And I think there is actually truth to what he was saying. But what he ended up saying in the end was basically, "John, if you think about it, you might even be able to do more good for your religion by not talking about Jesus, because you could get famous. And imagine what you could do for the poor if you had money. Imagine what you could do with your platform for Jesus if you would get bigger by not talking about him now." And I think one of the quotes he used was like, "Everybody loves Bono. Like, look at what Bono did. Everybody loves Bono, you know?" And the reason I say it was a very defining moment for me wasn't because it all of a sudden I said, "Oh, I'm going to start talking about Jesus now." It was a defining moment because I always had talked about Jesus. I had never heard that line of thought before. You know, I'd never heard that, no, by not doing this, you will be even more like Jesus. You know, it's even a better thing, a better way to evangelize by not saying anything. And it was a really important night. I went to the bus. I told my wife about it, prayed about it, I slept on it, woke up the next day, and I was like, that is so not what God is saying to me. It was so clear. It was so clearly evident that it kind of sounded like the truth, but it is not the truth. You know what I mean? And maybe I could be more famous. Well, maybe not. Who knows? But that's not what my goal is. That's not even the aim. And so I say it was a very defining moment for me because that prepared me for a journey that by the time 2015 came and all of a sudden you started seeing a lot of Christian pastors, influencers, artists begin to fall away from their faith and using all these various arguments that are like, no, I'm being more like Jesus by saying some new weird, you know, apostate type, you know, thing that is not actually more like Christ. But you know what I mean? It began to get tricky. Well, I was already prepared for that, and I had already been studying, and I was reading, trying to figure out where this stuff was coming from. So it was a very defining moment for me in which I knew that I cannot be silent about Christ. In fact, I need to be more vocal about Christ because there's something happening here that's very evil when the devil says stuff that sounds like truth, but it's really not. That's when you're getting into dangerous territory.